Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and I'm guessing there's another boss fight past this door. Is there another boss fight past this door? There, maybe? I don't know. Guinevere? Read message. Princess ahead, therefore try tongue. Am I ready? Face doesn't look familiar. It's probably not Guinevere. Oh, wait, well, no, it's Fillionor. What am I thinking? Was that bad? The thing was falling apart anyway. I just happened to be here when it broke. That's all. I don't think she's gonna believe me. So, wait, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Probably a bad thing. It appears that the princess is dead, or at least hollowed. Huh. So was I teleported, or was the whole thing an illusion to begin with? Probably teleported. Fillionor's Rest. Yeah, it looks like I can probably go back to wherever I was. Actually, I'll go back to the Church of Fillionor, and then pop back up, check out what's there. What do I see? I doubt it's much, but I don't know. Of course, now I'm wondering about the person who was talking about the spears, but you know, I'll talk to them later. I'm not going to assume they're that important. Also, I suppose I'm assuming some stuff about the nature of the world around me, but we'll see it, so. I assume it's still green and lush and at least looking okay on the top level, and I would be correct. However, I'm not sure how correct I am when it comes to what things look like inside here. Ah, I see. Well. Oh, whoops. Back to Fillionor's Rest, then. So I suppose this is the final area. Or I'm gonna guess this is the final area, I'm guessing. It's been like three bosses so far. There's usually like four or five in any given area. Or especially DLC for Dark Souls. I'm guessing it's... Okay, I realize Ashes was like two, but Ashes was remarkably tiny. Generally speaking, like Old Seal or the Dark Souls 2 DLCs, or even Old Hunters and Bloodborne, there's usually about five bosses, one of which optional. And given the sheer amount of summon signs... Okay, I'm guessing this is not a boss arena yet. So there's a big, wide open space. Angels? No. Something on the ground? Yes. A giant, wide open space that I can go anywhere in? That reminds me a lot of the area in Crown of the Ivory King, where you had to fight those two lion things. Yeah, that too. Now, what are you?
Oh, Fillionor. Help me, please. The Red Hood has come to eat us. To eat our dark souls.
All right, so I assume that going where you came from is the super final end of DLC boss. So let's go this way. I mean, there's that giant... Actually, I think this is the chapel I was looking at before, the one that was floating more or less in the sky. Okay, I'm standing on sand. That much is clear. There also doesn't appear to be a whole lot of places to go from here. I mean, part of me wants to think that if there's no remarkable landmark, it's probably nothing. But part of me has also learned that's not necessarily true. Okay, I'm starting to doubt there is anything back here around here. I'll explore the whole thing, but I seriously doubt there's anything worth exploring. I wonder if this area becomes a boss area later on. Like, this entire open desert is your boss arena. That would be interesting, though I don't know how they'd manage to make that actually work, because this would be a massive boss arena. Like, the amount of square meters this thing takes up is probably on par with most main levels. Granted, it's a wide open space rather than actually having any structure to it, but it's still a large, wide open space. Well, okay, I'm going to assume the structure in front of me is a sub-boss or secret boss or something like that. So, we'll see what's in there, and then go where that guy is crawling from. I wonder if there's something if he reaches Filianor, like something that you can see or that you get for having him do that. I'm not going to kill him. Seems pointless. They're not threatening me. Alright, so... likely boss arena. Okay.
I've searched for thee, dark, stricken creature. I am Shira, daughter of the Duke, descendant of gods, and trusted friend to Medea. At once, I
oh, hey,
am the honor
you're
the of
to
the
talk
gods,
to me.
The glory of fire, and the fear of the dark. Thou shalt not go unpunished for thy treachery, thy profanity, and thy shameless yearning.
See, I was wondering what you were going to say, and now you answered my question. Okay, forget Estusing, I've got to just cut you up. Oh boy. Ah, man, this is annoying. Oh, poise! Shoot, poise! Ah. So you gotta...
Try again to remember the great honor
man,
it was to be a
spirit. Why are you making a reactive enemy? Darn it, I don't know why FromSoft does this. Like, Dark Souls 3 has been full of enemies like this, where it's like you have to somehow roll on reaction. I've talked about rolls at length before, so I'm not gonna go belabor the point any further, but... seriously, what? Forcing you to react to something like that isn't good design. Like, that's not unreactable, but, like, way harder than it needs to be because, like I said, negative edge rolling. Hey. Alright, where's she coming in?
I've searched for thee, dark, stricken creature. I am Shira, daughter of the Duke, descendant of gods, and trusted friend to Medea. At once, I am the honor of the gods, the glory of fire, and the fear of the dark. Thou shalt not go unpunished for thy treachery,
how'd you hit me?
Thy profanity, and thy shameless yearning.
Well, we'll see about that. You only got to punish me once, so...
How would I ever forgive thy lowly kind?
Thanks to the Titanite's lab, by the way. I really appreciate that. Oh, and also thinking that I was actually on your side. Thanks for that. I'm on the side of humanity. Alright, so where is that weapon? Gotta remember to actually clean up this stuff. I mean, it was a weapon, right? It had to have been. They were using it. Ah, there it is. Crucifix of the Mad King. A cross spear hung with a malformed corpse. Once a Mad King was born to the Pygmy royalty, and Shira, Knight of Filianor, put him to rest. But Shira's cross spear, unable to kill the undying king, only pinned itself to him. Shira delivered them together to a dark room, where she stayed and held them close. Skill is Mad King's folly. Slam malformed corpse into ground to briefly awaken it. Then fillet with strong attack to trigger a roar of blessing or vexation. I don't think I can use it, probably due to intelligence requirements. And I would be correct. Which actually means I could experiment with it, because I can ring. Where's my ring? Scholar ring, here we are. So if I want to check it out. Smack, smack. It's like an axe or something. Yeah, it is an axe. Slam around, slam down. Mostly a bunch of slams down. Not probably a bad weapon for corridors. Okay, not great when dealing with anything other than crowds that are highly predictable, but not bad. And the art is... Oh, yeah, it's this. Wait, how do I... That's strange. Sorry, well, I was supposed to do what exactly? Slam more form corpse to the ground to be free to awaken it, and then fillet with strong attack. Okay, thank you. Okay, and it gives you a bit of a boost. Oh, apparently, I guess it's a poise boost. Alright, that's cool. Anyway, I need my steel protection ring, because I need my steel protection ring. And, oh, actually, I just remembered. There was actually a patch recently that modified some of the stats, the absorption difference with the prisoner's chain, and it looks like it's actually pretty minor now. It only reduces absorption by 3. So I might as well go back to that, because that's a useful thing to have, and an absorption difference of 3 is really not much, considering that Ring of Favor pretty much gives me the exact same thing except 3 extra stamina. But yeah, Prisoner's Chain, Ring of Favor do roughly the same thing, but Prisoner's Chain gives me only a small absorption penalty compared to what I have here. Like, bear in mind, before magic was like 8. No, yeah, magic was 8 and fire was like 6. It used to have a penalty of about 8 to 10 on absorption. Now it's only about 3. Like 2 or 3. That I can probably live with. And I mean it, like I can probably survive actually getting into fights now. Not necessarily get 2-shot despite having 1,000 HP. Which actually might... No, that doesn't mean much for anything else. I think it might mean I can change around some of the other rings, but no, I really want the Chloranthi ring. I wouldn't mind going back to the old Wolf's Knight Greatsword, which I actually can do. Oh, right, it wasn't Wolf's Knight. It was if I wanted to have Scholar Ring so I could use the... Where did the Ember Sword go? Firelight Greatsword. If I wanted to use this. Let's go back to Wolf's Knight, though. I only swapped out of it because I needed the weight for a bunch of extra protection rings. And Prisoner's Chain was not going to help me any. Like, Prisoner's Chain solves so many problems by existing. Especially with the way it was puffed in the last patch. Elder Ahead. Or Antlion Pit, one of the two. You know what occurs to me? That's actually one of those classic JRPG enemies that has never shown up in Dark Souls, is an Antlion. Or, no, sorry, it did show up. It showed up in Dark Souls 2 in the, what was it? The area after the Shaded Woods, I think, with the spiders. Can't remember the name of it now. Anyway, never mind, my mistake. Antlions have shown up, or Antlion Pits have shown up. But this is not one of those things. This actually might be the guy who was crawling towards Filianor. Or her desiccated corpse. Hmm. Oh. Oh. Is that one of those Herald Legion guys? I mean, it wouldn't be cutscening this for nothing.
What still here? Handed over that thing, your dark soul. For my lady's painting.
Ah. So that's how the girl at the top of the Arches of Ariandel DLC is relevant to this. Oh, you're gonna do the Artorias thing? Seriously? You better be at least as fun as Artorias to fight. Like, seriously, that was Artorias' intro, and you just took it. So you'd better be friggin' Artorias tier when it comes to boss fights. I mean, you're using the similar sword, at least. Alright. Oh! Okay. Well, you're using similar attack patterns as well. Are you Artorias, by chance? Ow. Well, I'm dead, for what it's worth. Hmm. Oh, so this entire area is considered a boss fight. I was right in the first place. This entire area is considered a boss fight arena. How about that? Good thing I dealt with the priestess now, before this came up. Okay, so I've got plenty of room to work with, but also this is way bigger than I... Actually, this is exactly as big as I expected. Way bigger than I thought reasonable. Ow, thought I would dodge that. Oh, there's no explosion. I expected an explosion. Alright. Oh, I can't believe I missed that. I mean, dodge that. Ow. Alright. Oh, crap! This is the exact thing I dodged! I'm done now, aren't I? I'm not done! I'm alive! I lived! For now! No! Would you please stop? It's not gonna kill me. We've established that. It's annoying. Okay. Ow. Maybe I shouldn't use the heavy sword, I don't know. It just feels so right to use it in this fight. Oh. Okay. Ow. No explosion, you're not blowing up the ground yet. Huh. An omission I find curious. Ah! Man. It's missing something compared to Artorias. I hope there's a second phase where it starts like throwing stuff in the ground and doing other things. It's pulling off some Artorias stuff, but it's like, I don't feel like it's deserved that corpse throw yet. That corpse fling, that's a statement. Also a similar statement that I take you seriously. Putting on my serious hat. Although, come to think of it, this might not be worth the prisoner's chain. Now, I mean, thinking about it, like, 900 HP compared to the amount of absorption that I'd get. That's this thing. Yeah, you know, I'm not gonna sweat it for now. I'm not taking that much damage. I'm getting, like, it's gonna be a difference between getting 3-shot and getting 3-shot. In fact, come to think of it, the sorcerer's hat may not help me in that respect either. But it also means I can't use the Wolf Knight Greatsword. Ah. Decisions. Hmm. If fire or magic becomes a relevant thing, I'll put on the serious hat. But considering the absorption I'm getting, I'm better off just switching back to the Ring of Favor if I want to have higher absorption. I just realized I haven't used my Ash and Estus flask in like two entire DLCs. Okay. Oh, nice. That came in handy. Eat sword! Okay, so you're doing a thing. And then jump. You're not gonna hit. Oh, you did hit me! She holds still for science, please. Good enough. Lightning bolts aren't worth it. Got it. Ow. Swing, swing, and jump! And I do my revenge kit! Oh, that felt good. Like, I'm showing you how you are ow! I was showing you how you are Artorias! Man, you're rude. I wonder if that's magic. It's probably dark knowing the area. Jump, and whack! Ow. Swing, 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 swing. Oh! Shoot, that goes really far. Ah, darn it. Ah, that was a waste of Estus, but okay, whatever. No jump? Okay. This guy's really hard to deal damage to. Maybe I should just try the longsword. I'm curious what the damage potential is of that. Just considering that I can chip away at him far faster with the longsword. Seems like it's probably the better idea. It's not as dramatic, and it doesn't make me feel like I'm actually getting revenge for you stealing Artorias's infamous or famous intro, but it'll do. That was not worth it. And jump! There we go. Okay, there we go. Phase 2. And hey, it's phase 2 on the same health bar. Thankfully. Oh, that is good. I'm glad it works that way. I'm kind of sick of the Dark Souls 3 uncertainty about boss health. Although I suppose I might still be worried about the full health. Okay, so
the blood of the Dark Soul.
Oh boy, that can't be good. Wait, what? Okay, so we're dealing with this kind of thing, huh? Ugh. You have a repeating crossbow? I want that! You better have that as one of your soul weapons when you die. Okay, so I'm guessing this is supposed to be a mix of Artorias and Fume Knight because of the way that you kind of have to dodge way behind them, although thankfully this is Dark Souls 3, not Dark Souls 2, so doing so is way easier. Aha, now we're in stage 3, are we? Okay! Okay, shoot. Ah, crap. I don't think I can do that again. That was my one shot. It's like, clearly I can do it, but now my heart's pumping too fast. Of course, that's assuming that what I was fighting was the final stage of the boss, and there isn't a third stage following the health bar draining to zero. Man, that was heartbreaking. damn it. Why must my heartbeat change? One more, and then I'll take a break. I don't want to stop. Properly judge health bar. Gonna use. Is that it? Yes!
single-digit tries! I'm actually improving at this game where this boss is the easiest boss in the game. I'm not sure which, but either way, I forgot I had embers available to heal if I needed them. But hey! Beaten Slave Knight Gale in, like, 8 tries. Actually, wait. The spear... I'm not going to count the Spear of the Church, because that was a fluke I managed to get. I actually got an AI opponent. It's funny listening back. I was complaining about it. I wish it was an AI, and it was an AI, because it turned out that was what it was. Because it was a disconnection problem on the side of the person who was supposed to be loaded up as my opponent, and as a result, Half-Light, who is the AI backup for the Spear of the Church fight, fought me instead, and I beat it in 1. This, I think, took 7 or 8 tries. Could have had it in 3 or 4 if I had just been a bit more patient at the very end, that 3rd or 4th try. But hey, I got it in 8, and that boss did not earn the Artorias corpse throw. It didn't. It was a neat boss to fight, though. It was still fun. Like, 9 out of 10 would fight again. But the... Actually, I might actually go and start being a Sunbro again. Help people out with this boss. I don't know if you need it, though. Actually, it might be harder, because I feel like the boss is designed around dueling, and if you start having other people in there, it gets confusing as to who it's going to hit. Dark Eater Meteor has the same problem, although Dark Eater Meteor is a lot harder to deal with than Gale. Anyhow, yeah, so it reminded me a bit of Artorias with the sword jumping around and such. It was lacking some... Actually, no, the second stage did bring in a few other things, but it felt kind of chaotic, and I didn't really worry about it in the same way that I worried about, say, the dark stuff that Artorias would throw down, or the... The other thing, there was another element of the Artorias fight. Actually, that was it. No, yeah, the only thing that was different is the exact moves used. But in terms of, yeah, jumping around, sorting around, that was actually pretty Artorias-y. You know what? I'll take back what I said. That earned the Artorias corpse throw. It was a successor. It felt like partially a successor to Fume Knight as well. And of course, there was the whole double attack thing that's been in there since Bloodborne with Maria. And of course, the Abyss Watchers in Dark Souls 3. But... Fume Knight, it reminded me of, partly because, you know, throwing a big wave of projectiles, bullet hell style with the white rings instead of the fireballs the Fume Knight throws, but also Fume Knight, the best strategy for fighting them is to try to stay behind them when they swing. In the second phase of Gale, the best strategy I found, was stay behind them as they swung. If you stay behind them, you're not going to get hit by the follow-up, which means it's a lot easier to avoid getting hit overall, and you can just deal damage. That's a bit harder when he starts exploding and throwing a bunch of soul bits everywhere, and then you have to deal with that, and the lightning, and the secondary attacks, and the more aggressive attacks he throws out there, which is effectively the third phase of the fight. But yeah. Also, it was nice to have Bloodborne-style multi-phase fights, where this one health bar, and then multiple phases you go along the health bars. Anyway, let's see what this guy's soul has. Please tell me it was that cool repeater crossbow. That, I am getting that. The sword is probably an ultra great sword that's outside of the weight class this character typically goes for. But a repeating crossbow. Okay, a second repeating crossbow. Avalyn is kind of a repeating crossbow. Avalyn's more semi-auto, I guess, or burst fire crossbow. Anyway, what do you got? What do you have for me? Repeating crossbow! Called it! Alright, so let's just see what the options are first. I mean, I'm going to go for the repeating crossbow, but, you know. Gale's greatsword. Oh, it's a greatsword. Man, game, why you gotta make me choose? I'm still going to go with the repeating crossbow, I think, but... Sword of the Slave Knight Gale, the only weapon that he kept with him from beginning to end. Originally an executioner's sword made for decapitation. This blade is heavily chipped and stained with the blood of countless battles. Skill is Blade of Peril, a precarious technique unique to undead Gale. Leap in any direction, slamming the greatsword to the ground, then follow with a normal attack for a large spinning slash, or a strong attack to backstep and jump forward in an overhead slam. Okay. That is basically what the boss was using. I mean, I've got Artorias moveset, so I'm just gonna stick with that. Repeating crossbow! This crossbow... Actually, is there anything special here? Physical? Critical? No, nothing is... No attunements or anything. Not attunements. Elements. Elements. This crossbow, customized for repeat firing to face mobs alone, was wielded by Slave Knight Gale. Used in the battles of an endless journey, this crossbow was covered with twists and dinks, rusted with blood, and made extremely brittle from overuse. Skill is repeat fire. Assume stance to activate repeat fire mechanism, and repeat fire with normal and strong attacks. I somehow doubt I can do that while left-handing it. You know, it's kind of funny. I feel like this was the easiest boss for me to fight in terms of tries. Although, also, this DLC, Like, there was no Sister Frida, which was an absurdly difficult boss. Like, really. Considering all the bosses, Frida was absurdly difficult. I'm actually kind of surprised it took me as many tries as it did when you consider that this guy took me, like, 8. The demons took me about 15 or so, which isn't great. The dragon took me 20, but still, that's nothing. Or 21. Yeah, I counted 21. That's still nothing. Like, I've died fewer times to bosses in this entire DLC, assuming this is the end of it, than to Sister Frida alone. And I've died less to any individual boss than any stage of Sister Frida. I don't know if that's because Sister Frida was so hard or because I wasn't quite in the mindset. I mean, I was playing much more cautiously in that fight with Gale. It paid off, too. Which is a thing I learned from fighting Frida. Like, just how to be careful, how to actually learn to prioritize avoiding getting hit before hitting yourself. You're not going to likely break their poise. So, yeah, that's the thing. That's the thing to bear in mind that I was not bearing in mind as well as I could have. Anyhow, this is a tough choice, but the thing is, a great sword's a great sword. I mean, it's all well and good, but I already have a great sword that works similarly, and I'd likely use that instead. Actually, what is the Artorias Greatsword, the Wolf Knight Greatsword, what is that's base power, just out of curiosity? I don't know if that affects the upgrade formula, but Wolf Knight Greatsword, 139, and this one is 147, so it's actually got a higher base power. It could theoretically be stronger, though the scaling isn't as good. Anyhow, I still don't remember the area I was referencing before. It's like just spiders and the crow lady that you trade souls for sometimes, and you fight Duke's dear Freya at the end of it. It's like some sort of mines or something. Why can't I remember the name of that place? Whatever, that at Antlions. Gale was not an antlion. Let's get a repeating crossbow. And let's also regret... Oh, wait, no, I don't have to regret anything! I got 120 or 115,000 souls. I'm gonna go mess around with this repeating crossbow. Actually, let's do a bit of messing around on camera, just to show what it does. Oh, what? Oh, interesting. Oh, I can do it! No, I can't. That was the... No, I guess I have to two-hand it to do the art. Okay. That would actually be kind of handy in PvP, come to think of it. I wonder if my other character could benefit from that. How heavy is this thing? 7.5! Holy crap! This might have actually been a bad idea. That is absurdly heavy. If I go back to Claymore, I might be able to wield it if I also use the one of the weight rings, like Havel's or something. Oh, wow. That's amazingly high. Of course, I really would like to have the stat boost, so I've got to think about how I'm going to do this. I got plenty of purging stones. I could probably just use those instead of the hollow rings. But yeah, this is absurdly heavy. Well. Yeah! I mean, it's a lot of bolts, but in a PvP situation, this would work really well. I found it interesting that I'm able to hold it, whereas my other crossbows, I'm fairly certain I did not have that option. Unless they changed something. Oh, they did! Oh, nice! That's actually pretty cool. Alright, well anyway, I'm gonna go deal with upgrade stuff, and we'll see if the rest of the DLC has anything worth looking at. Alright, so I think this... I don't know if this is the end. That felt kind of final bossy, although if I gotta be honest, that felt like prelude to final bossy, and yeah, this thing's fully upgraded now. The repeating crossbow? Fully upgraded. And also switched to heavy bolts because they're they're going to be stronger. Now, of course, the thing that I really want to know, more than anything, which actually I think I might have already found out, is, wait, this is the Kiln of the First Flame, isn't it? I didn't even notice this before, or at least didn't point it out. I kind of noticed, but I wasn't sure. Anyway, yeah, the... Is this it? I seriously expected there to be like 3 or 4 more episodes to do after this one, but it looks like... Well, we already explored the desert area up until this area here. So... I guess it is? I'll do it once over the DLC area just to make sure that I didn't miss anything, and also to test out this Kukumnu crossbow, though I did notice the attack rating is actually 14 lower than my light crossbow. Probably not a big deal, especially since the power of the repeating crossbowness is going to be coming in handy, I'm sure. But I'm... Yeah. Is there anything over here? Yeah, I'm not sure if there's anything left. I may have completed the DLC. You see, I expected something like the little girl above Sister Frieda's painting. Oh! Wait. Hang on. Okay, so I actually have a couple things I want to check first. First, I want to check Filianor. I assume their desiccated corpse means desiccated and lifeless. But let's actually find out. And of course, we know that the princess, or priestess rather, is dead. We killed her. Took a couple of good tries, but she is dead. You have nothing for me. The boss has been defeated. This area has... Oh, wait, what's this? A complete dead end. All right. I feel obligated to check the priestess, but I assume that not much has changed there either. I also don't remember where it is. Well, okay, I remember where it is. I'm just trying to remember the fastest path. Oh, hey! There is something worth here! But they're dead! The door's open! And we have her armor. Let's find out who this woman was. Shira's armor. Ooh, that's pretty. Armor of Shira, knight in service to Filianor, a rare women's piece from ancient times. With a spun gold shawl draped over the silver breastplate and a green woven skirt, this armor offers a subdued yet refined elegance, apropos to both a handmaiden of the princess and one whose veins course with royal blood. Alright, so what's the other stuff? Shira's crown of Shira, knight in service to Filianor, finely crafted with silver and fashioned with a pearl from a man-eater shell. Man-eaters. I'm sure I fought them before, I just can't remember them offhand. Shira delivered the crucified Mad King to a dark room, where she stayed in her formal wear, even though none would see her. So I think we're getting an idea of the royal struggles of the Ringed City. Shira's got... Oh, Slave Knight gauntlets. Oh, wait, right, yeah, that just happened to be a Slave Knight I fought. That is old armor. Which I think it is. Nope, that's what it is. Alright, where... Silver Knight... Shira's gloves. Oops. Alright. Gloves of Shira, knight in service to Filianor, crafted with Carthaman leather and graced with brass buttons. One article of Shira's knight garb. And the last bit is... Shira's leggings, most likely. Shira's trousers. Trousers of Shira, knight in service to Filianor. Made of Carthaman leather boots over a silk underlayer. One article of Shira's knight garb. Alright, so what do I look like with this on? Huh. I mean, the double skirt's a little redundant. It's not bad. It's got a weird filigree chainmail. Oh, it's plate mail. Never mind. Not trying the biggest fan of the shawl bit. Also, I'm not the certainly not the biggest fan of the absorption it does not have. Actually, you know, it's not bad. Come to think of it, it's pretty good non-physical absorption. But I already have a piece of armor that does that kind of better. Except for fire. And strike. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not something like Pont of Night, though. Or, of course, Dancers. What does Wolf Knight World look on me? Not great. Okay, never mind. Still, that's a lighter but still fairly serious hat. I'm still going to wear this now, actually. Aha! My mark of having defeated Shira. Oh, crap! Well, you know what? Let's see how this works! Oh! I mean, that's not great compared to a single shot, but... Oh, crap! Well... Ah, well. I laughed too... I cackled too soon. I shall have to reserve my cackling for the deaths of my enemies rather than simply stunning them with a massive hail of crossbow bolts. Lesson learned. Alright, I don't think there's anything else to worry about because Patches was dealt with. Shira has... given, well, I've found her armor, so that's cool. Which means my absorption is above 20 for... No, it's not. It's actually still pretty bad. Actually, come to think of it, though, if I don't have this ring... Yeah, it goes above 20 for magic. No, that's cool. I mean, it's not a big deal. It wouldn't have helped with Dark Eater any. I don't even know if that's an order thing, anyway. Like, if the fact that I win the order I did, where I beat Dark Eater Midir, then went back to Shira and told her about all that stuff, and then dealt with the rest of this... I don't know if that was relevant. Yeah, nothing else feels like it actually matters here. Like I said, I'll do it once over and then come back when I find stuff. Oh, that's what plunging attack does! Holy crap! No wonder they said to try plunging attack! It's a one-shot! Good thing I tried it. I mean, a little late for that now, but... Okay, that explains the design of those enemies really well. Oh, I missed this. Hello. So there was a staircase up here, huh? Oh shit.
Wow, I missed a lot up here. Well. At least that's been rectified now.
Many of us are by the fire. I speak. Behold, Finn, and let.
How do I get to that place? Ah. Okay, so you can actually fight the spirit of the church if you want to again. No, I don't. Have I sinned? Nope. And I'm not cursed? Awesome. All things are good. Yet another Titanite slab. Good thing I came back here. And a chunk. I kind of am curious if I actually missed that earlier, like if that was an enemy I could have fought before I fought the final boss, or if it's the thing you fight after you fight the final boss in order to get a Titanite's lab. I don't know. Looks like we're probably done, though. I mean, the victory lap is over. There were quite a few items I found, or almost over. Won't call it over until I go back to the bonfire down there. Actually, come to think of it, there's that other area I fought the priest in, or priestess in. I doubt that's changed, but it's worth checking. Yeah, before I continue, let's just read through some of the items I got, because I got quite a few in the way. So, white birch bow. A short bow crafted with white birch, endowed with light manipulating magic. The bow is a relic from the ancient land of sorceries that was swallowed by the abyss, most known for its folktale of the heroic abyss walker. Skill, unseen arrow. Arrows shot by large pulls of the bow were enchanted with a golden spell that turns them nearly invisible. Oh. No, it's just hidden in arrow. It's kind of neat, but not a thing I don't use bows very much, so. Cool to know, though. Also, did it have any particular... Oops. Did it have any particular... No, I had no element or anything. Alright, the next one is Murky Longstaff. A dark staff, apparently. The long-handed staff wielded by the Murkmen who rise from the depths. Slathered with a black murkiness and fit for dark sorceries. Skill is Chant from the Depths. Works with staff equivalent light or left or right hand, briefly boosts the strength of dark sorceries. And I think that was everything that I found for weapons. Kind of wish I'd cleaned this up further, sooner, but oh well. And then there was a... What's the other thing? I don't believe it was body armor. It was like... Ah, right, I remember. It was a sorcery. Great Soul Dregs. A sorcery that fires great dark soul dregs that have stewed for ages far within the deep. This sorcery is the highest form of deep soul. Some of the Murkmen who rise from the depths are possessed by soul dregs, which have a grave likeness to the human form. Alright, this is the thing I got from before. Alright, so... Yeah, everything else seemed to be upgrade materials, which is nice to have. Actually, did I don't know, that tower in the distance, I feel like that's got to be meaningful of something. It's just scenery. So the last thing to check, of course. Very last thing to check. Is that Gale was getting pigment for the little girl above Sister Frida. And I think Sister Frida said something about Uncle Gale or something like that to get her stuff to finish the painting. And I wasn't wrong to double check. I wonder if there's a boss fight incoming. Or wait, this is already on fire, wasn't it? Wait, Blood of the Dark Soul. Hang on, what's going on here? Did I not read something? Oh, I didn't. Blood of the Dark Soul. Blood of the Dark Soul that seeped from the hole within the Slave Knight Gale. Used as pigment by his lady in Ariandel to depict a painted world. When Gale came upon the Pygmy Lords, he discovered that their blood had dried long ago, and so consumed the Dark Soul. Let's see what happens.
My thanks. Ashen One, with this will I paint a world. Please tell me thy name. I would name this painting after thee. My thanks. I will paint a world of that name. 'Twill be a cold, dark, and very gentle place. And one day, it will make someone a goodly home. I wonder when Uncle Gale intends his return. I hope the new painting will be to him a gentle home.
Bad news, kid.
My thanks, I will of a cold one day.
Alright, so I doubt that's everything, because I'm sure there's something that comes out of the painting. I wonder what happens if I told her that I had no name. I'm actually kind of curious, like, does that cause her to just to freak out and fight me, or what? Or does she just go, oh, well, that's too bad. Well, I'll just name it, and then gives it a different name. I'll just name it, I don't know, Ariamis. Why not? That sounds like a good name, don't you think? Anyway, let's see if resetting the world progresses that at all, or if this is it. Because if this is it, then we're done. Like, done. Like, this Let's Play, to my knowledge, is over. I don't think there's anything more. If there is anything more, I'll do a bonus episode after this one, obviously. But this appears to be the final episode.
My thanks, I will of a one.
How did you die? Oh. Yeah, that would make sense. Oops. Well, finish this more or less where we started it. I hope you enjoyed that. Like, that whole thing. I realized that it was a bit of a frustrating thing overall, and there ups and downs. Like, both this DLC and the entire Let's Play. But, well, it's over. So, I hope it was fun for you guys to watch, because this was interesting to do a Let's Play that I've never done this before, and I don't know if I'll do it again. There's a couple of games I have in mind potentially a couple of years from now when they actually get released, but I don't have any plans for anything anytime soon. This was an interesting experiment, but I don't know if I'd want to do this again in the near future. So, I mean, of course, it's always the commentary stuff that I do normally. But yeah, so I hope you guys all enjoyed my first attempt at a Let's Play. I mean, if you're watched all the way this far, I greatly appreciate it. I mean, I'm glad you enjoyed it. I don't know what else to say, because clearly you must have enjoyed it if you stayed here that long. So thank you so much for watching and watching through the entire series, and putting up with my intermittent whining. At least this episode I was a fair bit more calm and composed and level-headed, so it didn't quite work out as, or it worked out well for a finale, but that's basically it. Assuming that there isn't anything I missed, and it looks like this painting is just a thing that's there to be there, and sort of a cliffhanger-y note, like an ending. Not really cliffhanger, but one of those endings where you kind of know how it's going to end, but you don't actually see the events, but you just know, yeah, that's concluded. So this is concluded. So I think this is the best thing to say. Yes, we did it! We're done! I did a complete Let's Play! And beat all the bosses in this game, to my knowledge. And all the side characters as well. And got all the covenants, as far as I'm aware. So it was a pretty complete run. As 100% as I could make it, given the fact that I'm playing it blind. Yes! Good night, everyone!